Each of the following functions has a graph that is increasing. If you calculated the average rate of change between sequential equal sized intervals, which function can be said to have an average rate of change that is A, constant, B, increasing, C, decreasing? Well, first of all, notice that each graph is increasing. Graph A rises from left to right. Graph B rises from left to right. Graph C also rises from left to right. All three graphs are increasing. However, they increase in different ways. Graph A is curving in an upward direction. Graph B is curving in a downward direction. Graph C doesn't curve at all. Graph C is the graph of a straight line. So which one has an average rate of change that is constant? An average rate of change that is increasing or decreasing? Well, to answer that question, we need to clearly understand average rate of change. In order to find the average rate of change between two points, what you do is you find the change in y and divide by the change in x. I'm going to use delta y to indicate the change in y and delta x to indicate the change in x. Okay, well, it says if you calculated the average rate of change between sequential equal sized intervals. Okay, to create equal sized intervals, what we do is we pick x values along the x-axis that are the same distance apart. So for all three graphs, I've picked x1, x2, and x3 the same distance apart. And then I've plotted the corresponding points on the graph of each function. The distance between the x values, that's called the change in x. And because we've picked equal sized intervals, the delta x is going to be exactly the same for each piece. So let's go ahead and indicate that. Okay, this will be delta x. This will also be delta x. And each of the blue pieces is exactly the same length. Each one will be delta x in length. Now we can see that the change in y is different. So we'll go ahead and label each of those. Okay, here we have delta y. And to indicate that it's different, I'm going to call this first one delta y1. And then the second one, delta y2. So let's focus on graph A for the moment. Notice that delta y1 is a lot smaller than delta y2. So over here under graph A, I'm going to write delta y1 is less than delta y2. Now we want to compare not the change in y's, but we want to compare the average rate of change. So we need to divide by delta x. Delta x1 and delta x2, they're both exactly the same. So we can just divide both sides by delta x. And since delta x is a positive number, the direction of the inequality is going to stay exactly the same. And so what we see is that the average rate of change from x1 to x2, that's this first average rate of change, is going to be less than the average rate of change from x2 to x3. So since the first average rate of change is less than the second average rate of change, that means that the average rate of change is increasing. So for graph A, we want to indicate that the graph is increasing, but it also has an increasing rate of change. So for graph A, that goes under B. So we write graph A. Graph A has an increasing rate of change. If we look at graph B, we notice that delta y1 is bigger than delta y2. So we'll go ahead and indicate that delta y1 is greater than delta y2. if we divide both sides by delta x, then we can compare the average rates of change. And what we see is that the average rate of change from x1 to x2 is bigger than the average rate of change from x2 to x3. The slope is getting smaller. We have positive slope, but then a smaller positive slope going from x2 to x3. So because the average rate of change is getting smaller, the average rate of change is decreasing. So the answer to C is graph B. So even though the function is increasing, its average rate of change is decreasing. And then finally, for graph C, we notice that delta y1 and delta y2 appear to be the same. So we have delta y1 and delta y2. They appear to be the same. And so we'll write delta y1 is equal to delta y2. And then to get the average rate of change, we divide by delta x. And we can see that the first average rate of change is equal to the second average rate of change. And that indicates that the average rate of change is constant. And so A corresponds with graph C. So just in summary, if you see that a graph is curving in an upwards direction, then it has an increasing rate of change. If you see that a graph is curving in a downward direction, then it has a decreasing rate of change. And if you see that the graph is a straight line, then it has a constant rate of change.